breaking news. Well, it's not breaking news. It was actually last night. An interview with ABC News. Rick Santorum says that states should have the right to outlaw birth control. Yeah. In fact, he had said last year, he said, one of the things I will talk about that no president has talked about before, I think the dangers of contraception in this country. It's not okay. It's a license to do things in the sexual realm that is counter to how things are supposed to be. I want to share with you in a little bit about Griswold versus Connecticut in 1965 and how things used to be. But Santorum is like, you know, on the uptick in Iowa right now. And let's get the latest on how the voting side of this. We got a report from John Nichols in the previous hour about, you know, what's going on the ground and how the candidates are stacking up, as it were, falling apart, or the wacky positions. Let's talk about the actual process. Gingrich says that while Acorn, this is incredible, while Acorn committed massive voter fraud, his massive voter fraud is just a mistake. Brad Friedman is the expert on all things voting. He is the editor and publisher of bradblog.com and is with us. Brad, welcome back.
Hey, Tom. Great to be here. Happy New Year to you, my friend.
Thank you. And the same to you, too. And in fact, I see we don't have you on Skype. I'm surprised. What's the story here? Gingrich committed voter fraud?
Well, Gingrich committed voter fraud if you consider what Acorn did to be voter fraud. And it actually wasn't Acorn at all. It was Acorn's handful of workers for Acorn. You'll recall that Republicans and, in fact, Newt Gingrich himself for years have been decrying that Acorn had committed voter fraud. And they would do this every time one of Acorn workers were found to have submitted fraudulent registrations. Right. Now, in the case of Acorn, they actually checked all of those registrations, discovered the fraud, and turned them in to officials and turned in the folks who committed the fraud, because it was Acorn themselves who was being defrauded by these workers.
So Acorn never actually submitted fraudulent registrations to the government.
Well, they actually did submit them, but they would be flagged as fraudulent because by law, Acorn has to turn in any registration that anybody signs and turns into one of their users.
Okay. So now, in the case of Newt Gingrich trying to get on the ballot in Virginia, he turned in 11,500 signatures. He was required to turn in at least 10,000 registered Republicans, and...
And what he now claims is that 1,500 of those signatures were fraudulent. He claims, he told a voter this in Iowa, it's caught on videotape, he said that 1,500 of those signatures were fraudulent, were submitted by just one guy on their campaign. Notably, he doesn't give the name of this guy. And because of those fraudulent signatures, he did not have enough signatures to get on the ballot, the primary ballot, in his home state of Virginia this year.
Right, to hit that 10,000 mark.
Yeah, exactly.
And
now,
so he
didn't check his campaign, apparently, unlike Acorn, his campaign did not bother to check those 1,500 signatures before turning them in to make sure to find out if they were legitimate or not. So if you use the Fox News Republican Party standard that they have been using for years to declare that Acorn had committed voter fraud, when in fact they never, ever did, then by that very same standard, Newt Gingrich himself committed massive voter fraud in the state of Virginia, and worse case than Acorn ever did.
Right, or at least his campaign. And
that's right.
And probably this is because he was paying people to collect signatures, which Acorn...
They were paying people to collect signatures, but I think more importantly, you know, up until this year, the Republican Party in Virginia never bothered to check those signatures to make sure that they were legitimate. They would just rubber stamp the process. The parties themselves are allowed to determine whether the signatures turned in, whether there were enough signatures turned in or not, but due to a lawsuit this year, the Republican Party said, you know what, we better check these signatures.
So now the way Fox is dealing with this basically is when Acorn was submitting about 1.5 or 6% fraudulent signatures that were flagged as fraudulent. Do not use these. We caught these. That was called voter fraud. But when Newt Gingrich submitted about 15% of his total as fraudulent signatures, did not flag them, did not identify them, and in fact tried to get on the ballot based on them, that was not voter fraud. That was a mistake.
According to Newt's own words to this woman, he said, oh, no, that was, quote, just a mistake. And that same mistake, when Acorn made it, was massive voter fraud, according to them, and according to Newt, who himself back in, I believe it was 2009, in an op-ed in the Washington Examiner, actually charged that Acorn had committed massive voter fraud, when in fact they never had, but he was basing it on these reports, this handful of workers who had turned in fraudulent registrations, who had been flagged by Acorn themselves.
You know, the bigger picture here, Brad, is that the Republicans have been using this canard of voter fraud for years and years and years as an excuse to prevent people from voting, to reduce the number of people who can vote, knowing that if they can reduce the number of people who vote, they will first and foremost probably reduce the most disenfranchised among us, the poorest, the people who have to work on Tuesdays, the elderly, students, people who typically tend to vote Democratic, and that will work to their advantage, and they use this to take apart Acorn, which was a very effective organization for registering to vote people who were largely in urban areas, people of color, people who were poor. And really, that's what this is all about, isn't it? I mean,
yeah, that's exactly what this is all about. And I should add, by the way, that there is no evidence, none, that any fraudulent vote was ever cast vis-a-vis one of those bad Acorn registrations in any election at anywhere at any time. None.
Right.
So when they say Acorn committed voter fraud, it is a complete and utter lie. Not a single, Mickey Mouse never voted.
Right.
Dick Tracy never voted. Complete lie.
Right. But Mickey Mouse did vote 1,500 times for Newt Gingrich.
Apparently
in Virginia.
So. Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Now,
so
now to underscore that in Iowa tonight, where the Republican Party themselves set their own rules where they can have any rules they want. In fact, they are having an election where no photo ID is required to either vote or to register for the first time and vote right there and then at the polls.
Wow.
So either they're in favor of voter fraud in their own election tonight, in their own caucuses tonight, or they know the truth, which is that polling place voter fraud is incredibly rare, doesn't happen, and they are smart enough not to turn away their own voters in a Republican caucus, but in an election where Democrats are participating, that's a different story entirely, and those people must be stopped from voting.
Right, although they are starting to have second thoughts now about the Ron Paul, the possibility that the Ron Paul people will show up and steal the crown from Mitt Romney.
Steal it by getting to cast their legal vote, you mean?
That's right, yes.
Yes.
Steal it would be their phrase, not mine. Win.
Exactly.
Yeah, and in fact, they've got a whole system there that will prevent that from happening, even if
it's extraordinarily
Ron Paul gets the most votes.
What's going on in Iowa? I mean, the no photo ID is necessary. You can register on the same day and vote on the same day. And, by the way, they're using hand-counted paper ballots at the polling place. All of these things are things that Republicans have fought against in all of the other elections, including in Iowa itself, where the Republicans in the State House tried to pass a photo ID measure earlier this year.
Amazing.
Unbelievable.
No photo ID, no voting machines, voting on paper. Incredible. Incredible.
Yep.
They've got to figure it out. Brad Friedman. Brad, thank you very much for being with us.
Always my pleasure.